In this video, we briefly introduce the idea of electric field, and then we're going to work a couple examples of calculating an electric field and calculating a force due to an electric field. So we start with this isolated positive point charge, and we're going to call this the source charge. And Coulomb's law says that this source charge would exert a repulsive force on any positive charge in the vicinity. So I'm going to just draw one real quick. And we would normally call that second charge the test charge. It's the one that we're using to feel what the original source charge is doing. So if there was a test charge in the vicinity, it would be pushed away from that source charge. But what if there isn't a test charge in the neighborhood of this source charge? Hopefully you agree that there should still be something going on around this source charge. And the idea is that the space around the source charge is filled with an electric field that would exert an electric force if we introduced a charge. The direction of that electric field is given by the direction the force would point on a positive test charge. So it looks like this. Again, that electric field is pointing away from the source charge because that's the direction a force would be applied to a positive test charge if one happened to be there. One thing I want to point out before getting quantitative with this is that you can see the spacing of the field lines becomes denser as I get closer to that positive charge. And that's a way of saying the electric field is stronger there. In other words, the force on a positive charge would be greater there. So to get quantitative about electric field, I can say the electric field is the force per unit charge. And our units of electric field would then be newtons per coulomb. Turning this around, I can say the electric force on a test charge is given by the magnitude of that test charge multiplied by the electric field vector. So I can see from the second equation that if I doubled the magnitude of the test charge, it would then double the force experienced by the test charge. So on the left-hand side of this slide, I want to figure out what's a formula for the electric field surrounding a point charge. Now we are going to look at other distributions of charge besides just a point charge, but this one comes up a lot. So I want to find the electric field in the space surrounding this source charge. So quoting the definition of the electric field as the force per unit charge felt by a test charge, that Q would be Q test. Well, Coulomb's law gives me a way of writing the force between the two charges. So that's going to be K, Q source, Q test, over the distance between them squared. And then I'm dividing that by the magnitude of the test charge. All right, so the test charge is going to cancel out of this thing. And it gives me a formula for the electric field surrounding a point charge. That allows us then to answer a question like this first example. Compute the electric field at a distance of 1 meter from a 1 microcoulomb charge. All right, so we could go in any direction to do this as long as we're 1 meter away from that source charge. And the electric field is going to be a vector assigned to each point in space. Again, pointing away from this positive source charge because that's the direction the force would be on a positive test charge. Then we apply our formula real quick. The electric field generated by a point source is going to be KQ over R squared. And we plug in the numbers. The Coulomb's law constant is 8.99 times 10 to the ninth newton meter squared per coulomb squared. The magnitude of our source charge is 1 microcoulomb, which is 10 to the negative 6 coulombs. And the distance between the source charge and the point that we're interested in is 1 meter. And when I run the numbers, I get 8,990. And the units of electric field, again, that's units of force divided by units of charge. So that's newtons per coulomb. Another way to describe this is that if you were to put 1 coulomb of charge at that point, 1 meter away from our source charge, it would feel a force of 8,990 newtons. Let's look at a more reasonable magnitude of charge, though. We're going to put an electron at this location. And an electron has a charge of negative QE, if I'm keeping track of signs, where QE is the elementary charge, and I get negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs for that. And once I have an electric field, it's very simple to find the force that it exerts on a test charge. You just multiply the charge of the test charge by the electric field at that point in space. So that's really just turning this original formula for E around, and I write F equals QE. Now, if I keep my minus sign, then it indicates that I have an attractive force going on. Alternatively, you can just make better diagrams and do all your calculations in terms of magnitudes instead of keeping the signs. But I'll go ahead and keep that minus sign this time. So I have negative 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19. That's the charge on the electron, multiplied by the strength of my electric field there. I'll go ahead and show you what's going on with the units. The Coulombs cancel, and I get newtons. So I get a force of negative, indicating that it's an attractive force, 1.44 times 10 to the negative 15 newtons on this electron. Now that might seem like it's an incredibly small force, but the mass of an electron is incredibly small, so the acceleration would be enormous. If you find the physics content on Zach's lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.